Hi, today I'm going to talk to you all about a fabric that's better than cotton and linen for regular use. It is nothing but silk. Silk, in addition to being a very breathable fabric, is superior to cotton and linen because of these additional features. Number one, it allows transpiration of sweat from your body to the surrounding environment while not retaining any amount of humidity within the fabric. So this decreases the chances of microbial colonization, as in bacterial colonization, which can trigger certain skin conditions such as atopic dermatitis, and also fungal colonization or yeast colonization, which can trigger body acne in people. So other than this, the fabric is also extremely soft in comparison to the other fabrics like cotton or linen or polyester. So the surface is extremely smooth due to the tightly woven fibers, and it does not cause friction against the skin. So the extremely pruritic skin conditions where the itch receptors are already overexcited tend to get calmed down when you wear silk fabric. But in certain conditions such as atopic dermatitis, where the flexural area such as your neck or your underarms or the hips or groins are involved, the friction that is minimally caused even by silk fibers cannot be tolerated. So in these conditions, a new fabric was invented. It is called as Micro Air Derma Silk. It has a little bit of stretch component to it and makes it superior to the regular silk that is available. Now, silk fiber has been used in pillowcases, for your rubber bands, in garments and sleep masks. All of these is because of decreased microbial colonization and also zero chances of friction, that makes it good for your hair fibers as well, as it does not cause destruction of the cuticle of your hair fiber, so the entanglement is minimized. Silk fabrics also maintain the body for a longer time, as in the fibers do not become loose, altering the shape of the fabric. So this has been used largely in manufacturing face masks. Of course, they are not superior to N95 face masks and cannot be used in medical personnel, but for your regular use, it is better than using a cotton mask or a polyester mask, which are largely being used nowadays. One drawback for silk fabric is that it cannot be washed, machine washed or hand washed, and it has to often be sent for dry cleaning. And the chemicals that could be used during dry cleaning may not suit sensitive skin types. So be able to differentiate between satin and silk, because commercially satin pillowcases, satin rubber bands are being sold as silk and usually are much more affordable in comparison to silk fabric. But again, your necessity of maintaining good skin and hair with the help of silk is not met with if you're using a satin or polyester or mixed fabric. Silk is usually of two different kinds. One is the mulberry silk, which is obtained from these domesticated silkworms. The other one is lyosilk, which you can get from plant cellulose. So personally, I feel mulberry silk is widely accepted and available in comparison to lyosilk. And today I'm wearing this piece of a Thai silk fabric tunic, and I brought it out from my closet after a long time just to make this video.